So the question today is, who is the Antichrist? And my name is Shane Chadwick. I'm the pastor of Home Church Amarillo. I got my church here with me this morning. And everyone wants to know, who is he? And let me start by telling, before I get to the who of Antichrist, let me get to the what of Antichrist. What Antichrist is, and then I'll finish with who he is. Now, he has many names or titles. He's called the Man of Lawlessness, the Son of Perdition. The Apostle John is the only one that calls him the Antichrist. He's called Liar, the Deceiver, the Abomination of Desolation. And John, where he uses the term Antichrist, is found both in 1st and 2nd John. 2nd John chapter 7 says, "For many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not confess the coming of Jesus Christ in the flesh. Such a one is the deceiver and the Antichrist." And in 1 John 2:22, he says this, "Who is the liar but he who denies that Jesus is the Christ? This is the Antichrist, he who denies the Father and the Son." Now, what's a little bit interesting about these Antichrists that John's referring to is what he says prior to verse 22. In verse 18 through 19, he gives a warning. He says, "Children, it is the last hour. And as you have heard that Antichrist is coming, so now many Antichrists have come. Therefore, we know that it is the last hour. They went out from us." Pay attention to this. "They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that it might become plain that they all are not of us." So the last hour began when? When do you think the last hour began? Not a trick question. At the death and the resurrection of Christ. That's when the clock started ticking. It's the last hour. We call it the church age, and it is. But John has cleared that these antichrists came out of where? They came from us. Came from the church. I mean, they ain't coming from the satanic temple. These guys, according to John, came out of the church. They were false Christians that denied the gospel message preached by John, that was preached by Paul, preached by the other apostles. They deny that Jesus is the Son of God. They deny that Jesus is the Christ or the Moshiach, the Messiah in Hebrew, prophesied in the First Testament. They deny that Jesus Christ came in the flesh. They deny God the Father, and they reject the truth of the gospel. Now, if they were true Christians, according to John, and believers of the truth, it says they would have what?
Still been with them.
That has still been with them. They would have remained. But they weren't Christians. They exchanged the truth for a lie and then tried to deceive the true believers. The next verse about these antichrists should definitely serve as a warning to those who hear the truth and reject it. Hebrews 6:4 through 6 says, "For it is impossible in the case of those who have once been enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift and have shared in the Holy Spirit and have tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the powers of the age to come and then have fallen away, to restore them again to repentance, since they are crucifying once again the Son of God to their own harm and holding Him up to contempt." So if there are many antichrists, who is the antichrist? Jesus warned His disciples on the Mount of Olives about this coming antichrist. In Matthew 24:15, He says this, "So when you see the abomination of desolation spoken of by the prophet Daniel standing in the holy place," let the reader understand, "then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Let the one who is on the housetop not go down to take what is in his house, and let the one who is in the field not turn back to get his cloak. And alas, for women who are pregnant and for those who are nursing infants in those days, pray that your flight may not be in winter or on a Sabbath." Who's he talking to here? He's talking to the Jews. For then there will be great tribulation, such as not been from the beginning of the world until now, no, and never will be. And if those days had not been cut short, no human being would be saved, but for the sake of the elect. Who are the elect here? They're the Jews. He's talking to the Jews about the Jews or something that's coming to the Jews. And he's saying that the elect in this reference is to the Jews. Those days will be cut short. In fact, in chapter 6 of Revelation 6:2 says, "And I looked, and behold, a white horse, and its rider had a bow, and a crown was given to him, and he came out conquering and to conquer." And John goes on in Revelation 13 and talks about him. He says, "I saw a beast rising out of the sea with 10 horns and 7 heads with 10 diadems," that's crowns, "on its horns and blasphemous names on its head. And the beast that I saw was like a leopard. Its feet were like a bear and its mouth was like a lion's mouth. And to it, the dragon," who's the dragon? The dragon is Satan. And it says, "And to it, the dragon gave his power and his throne and great authority. One of its heads seemed to have a mortal wound, but its mortal wound was healed." Who does that sound like? Someone that died and somehow comes back to life.
Jesus.
Yeah. "And the whole earth marveled as they followed the beast. And they worshiped the dragon, for he had given his authority to the beast. And they worshiped the beast, saying, 'Who is like the beast? And who can fight against it?' And the beast was given a mouth, uttering haughty and blasphemous words. It was allowed to exercise authority for 42 months. Anybody know how long that is? That's 3.5 years. It opens its mouth to utter blasphemies against God, blaspheming his name and his dwelling. That is, those who dwell in heaven. Also, it was allowed to make war on the saints and to conquer them. And authority was given it over every tribe and people and language and nation." The whole world under his authority. "And all who dwell on earth will worship it. Everyone whose name," this is important, "whose name has not been written before the foundation of the world in the book of life of the Lamb who was slain." Now, there's a lot of scripture. In fact, we're going to go right into Daniel. You know, he referenced the book of Daniel. And it describes the Antichrist like this in verse 36 through 9 in chapter 11. It says, the king shall do as he wills. He shall exalt himself and magnify himself above every god, shall speak astonishing things against the God of gods. He shall prosper till the indignation," that word in Hebrew is za'am, it actually means wrath. "He shall prosper until the wrath is accomplished, for what is decreed shall be done. He shall pay no attentions to the God of his fathers, or to the one beloved by women." So he's talking about pagan gods. "He shall not pay attention to any other god, for he shall magnify himself above all. He shall honor the god of fortresses instead of these, a god whom his fathers did not know. He shall honor with gold and silver, with precious stones and costly gifts. He shall deal with the strongest fortresses with the help of a foreign god. Those who acknowledge him he shall load with honor. He shall make them rulers over many, and shall divide the land for a price." Now, Paul says that there have been many antichrists. Many even suggested that Antiochus IV, whose nickname was Epiphanes. Anybody know what Epiphanes means? It means God manifest. Nero, right? I keep talking about Nero coming. Wicked guy. Made himself a god. They sent Titus into Jerusalem later, and he was truly an abomination in the place. Put pigs into the Jerusalem temple. Hitler killed 6 million. You think he was an antichrist? 6 million Jews. I say all these things because I see videos on YouTube. They're constantly trying to say, "Hey, this is the antichrist." I've seen bazillions of them. 2 Thessalonians 2:3-8 says this: "Let no one deceive you by any means, for that day will not come unless the falling away comes first." This true rebellion comes against God. You think we're seeing pieces of that now? True rebellion against God. "And the man of sin is revealed." That's the son of perdition. That's this antichrist who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God or that is worshiped, so that he sits as God. in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Do you not remember that when I was still with you, I told you these things, and now you know what is restraining, that he may be what? Something is restraining so that the Antichrist will be revealed in his own time. That's why I say you can speculate all you want to. For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord will consume with the breath of his mouth and destroy with the brightness of his coming. So my questions to anyone naming the Antichrist are these. Who is restraining? And has he been taken out of the way? Just look up. Luke 21, 28 says, now when these things begin to happen, this chaos in the world begins to happen, he says, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption draws near. And I believe it's closer than it's ever been. So until next time, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and he will add all things unto you.